Today we're going to make a homemade contact mic out of a piezo element and a mono cable, some hot glue, and a bottle cap. No solder necessary. The bottle cap I've drilled a small hole in, so you can see for the wire to fit through on the side. So take the wire, and you can get this wire at Radio Shack for about $3. Piezo elements are about $2. Sometimes these come in a black case. It's kind of hard to get off, but I usually use a pair of pliers. But these are fragile, so be careful with them. So take the wire and thread it through the side of the bottle cap. I made this kind of tight so that it would stay in there. Now pull the leads out, the one in the middle there with the shielding. Should be black, and this one should be red on the wires connected to the piezo. Take those and spin them together. Try and make a good connection so it kind of braids itself. Now, once that's done, you're gonna not want those touching each other once they all get glued in there. So I'm just gonna take a piece of tape. Should use electrical tape or something like that, but all I have is packing tape, which will work just fine because it's all getting covered in glue in a second. Cover those leads up as best you can. And now you have prepared your piezo and its house. Cram all that in there, making sure your wires aren't crossing. The slack and the piezo element you can just fold in there. Now what I'm gonna do is fill this with hot glue first. Get those wires stuck down in there. I'm going to fill this completely. Right now, I just want to get the wires stuck so that they're not in our way. And once I've got those down, I can begin to fill it. Once you fill it near the brim, then you stick the piezo element into it, pushing down softly, so that it's raised above a little bit. And after that, once the glue begins to dry, you can push down on it on a flat surface like a desk and make sure that it's flattened up against there. You can also cover it with hot glue if you want, but that might kill a little bit of the sensitivity. Once it's all dry, you should have something that looks like this. You can plug the other end into an amp, hook that to an acoustic guitar with some poster putty or some tape, or hook it to any variety of surfaces and see what kind of sounds you can find. You can also use one of those as a trigger.